coming to you from a rainy, strangely cold spring day here in the Cottondale Valley. I'm all cozied up, I've got a little blanket on my legs. I just thought I would take this opportunity when the rain stopped to film my September wrap-up video. So I'm just going to go through the books that I read in September. I did vlog a bit and you got my initial impressions. But I thought I'd run through them from my least favourite to my most favourite book for all the books that I've read in September this year. So, my least favourite book, if you've watched my vlog, this is not a surprise, is The Lost Daughter by Elena Ferrante. The woman in this book drove me to anger. I was so furious with her. And for who she was as a mother and the selfishness of the story, all of it upset me. It was an unnecessary book for me to read. This is the second Elena Ferrante that I've read. Obviously I read My Brilliant Friend. I gave that 2 stars. I thought I would give this a go. I gave this 3 stars simply because I appreciated how the writing got me so moved, and even if it was towards anger. I'm kind of done with Elena Ferrante. I might try another one eventually after I've calmed down a bit, but yeah, this is my least favorite book. My second least favorite book for the month, I'm kind of a bit worried to say, is Life After Life by Kate Atkinson. I know this author is so highly regarded and she's just brought out a new book, I think. But this book to me frustrated me. It had an unusual plot about, you know, a woman being able to, I guess, reincarnate or come back to life to change the course of how her life was progressing. But I found that it posed a lot of questions and didn't answer a lot of. And the wrap up for me was frustrating, and it didn't work, this book, for me. So it's my second least favorite. Then I read The Animators, which was just a book. It was a good book. There's nothing wrong with it. It was about a friendship that was beautiful and loving, and about the dependency of that friendship. Nothing's striking me now as I try to remember about it. Of course, I remember the plot, but it's really just one of those easy reading. It didn't wow me. It was a 3-star book for me. It was good. And then Eleanor. This disappointed me, not because it was bad writing. I really enjoyed Eleanor. She is cool. I like her. She could totally be one of my best friends, the way she talks, the way she acts. This is a product of watching too much BookTube and getting excited about a book for too long before I actually read it. The twist at the end was, I guessed it. So I guess when that happens, it kind of taints the rest of the book. For me, it does anyway. So, I was just disappointed in the twist. I wanted it to be, I wanted it to come out of nowhere. So, yeah, this is middle of the road for me for the month, which surprised me. This was the most surprising, yeah. And then Julian Barnes, The Sense of an Ending. I read this after Life After Life, and as I've already said, this wrap-up was just so much better than Life After Life. I guess this is a book about how you see your memories and the memories you have of certain people and a certain place in time and your past can be tainted really by what you want it to be. So that was a really cool exploration of that. I've never thought about that before. So that got me thinking about a lot of things. But it was clever. I really enjoyed the writing. It was to the point, which I really needed at the time that I read this book. So I gave this 4 stars. I really liked it. Then I think one of the first books I read was The Restorer. When I read the back, I thought this was just about a marriage breakdown and them trying to pull it back together, but this is about hugely about domestic violence. It touched just really serious parts in my being. It was so scary. It was the first book I've read that really explained what it's like to be a woman in a violent relationship, and also what it's like to be a girl in a violent relationship, you know, whose father is violent. It was horribly sad. But Michael Sala, just great writing. Like, it was compelling, and he approached all of the really hard themes and all of the really hard moments in these people's lives with real eloquence, and I really enjoyed his writing. He's an Australian author, so I'm going to delve into more of his works for sure. I loved this book. I originally rated it 4 stars, but a couple of days later I upgraded that to 5 stars because I just kept thinking about it. It stayed with me. It really, really touched me, this book. So I highly recommend reading The Restorer. And then The Boy in the Striped Pajamas. If you watch my vlogs, I cried like a baby. This is such a sad book. It's so cleverly written. I love John Boyne as a writer. This is the second book of his that I've read, and it's just brilliant. It's from a little boy's perspective whose father is the head of a concentration camp, but he is so completely innocent and so completely unaware of his father's roles and his role, not his role, but who he is in terms of a Nazi or a Jew. And when he befriends one of the kids on his father's concentration camp, they form this friendship that highlights how naive little Bruno is. It's so terribly sad. It's so terribly beautiful. It's an amazing book, and it's only a little one. If you can get your hands on it, absolutely do, and absolutely read it. I love this book. I love it. I love it. And then my favourite book for September is Fates and Furies, which I just finished and I just spoke about in my last vlog. This is about a marriage, essentially, but the only problem I have with this book is kind of this constant theme that runs through books about marriages that I'm finding, maybe I'm reading the wrong ones, is that a happy marriage means that one person has to give in and change who they are and change and hide parts of themselves, hide who they really are. In this book, Lotto is a creative husband who is supported by his wife Mathilde, who it becomes clear in the second part of the book, which is told from her perspective, that Lotto doesn't, her husband doesn't really know who she is, that she hides all of these true feelings from her husband. And I found that really sad because he was so in love with her and he was so happy to be married to her. He was a famous creative man who stayed loyal to his wife, and I just found it sad that she had to pretend to be something else. Not for him to love her, but she made that choice. Does that make sense? I really think that you can be happily married and be yourself. I don't think that should, you know, be an issue, but it just seems to me that the books I'm reading about marriages kind of highlight that. The first half of the book is from Lotto's perspective and the second half, like I said, is from Mathilde's perspective. The first half of the book is wonderful. It's just a story about the evolving nature of Lotto's career and their marriage. And like I've said before, it brings up a lot of things which are then tied up in the second part of the book, which I think is just well done. Because I've read a couple that haven't been so well done. So I really, really appreciated that. I also really appreciated Lauren Groff's writing. It's descriptive without being boring. It's beautiful. She can tell a story as well as set the scene. So that, you know, sometimes you read those books and they're setting the scene for ages, you know, and she's to the point yet poetic in her words. Am I making sense? I hope so. I just loved this book. I loved it a lot. Gave it 5 stars. Highly recommend. And I would love to read more of her work as well. So that's the 8 books I've read. 8 books I've read for September. I had a great reading month. I had sort of 3 5-star books and a 4-star and a few 3 stars and one that really got me going. It's the last day of September today. I thought I might be able to plow through this before the end of it, but I'm only 80 pages in. Today is grand final football day. And in Queensland, where I live, that's a big deal. And especially because our team is playing in the grand final, so we must, it's mandatory that we eat pies and we drink beer and we watch the footy all afternoon. So that's not very conducive to reading a book. So I don't know if I'm going to finish this one, but I'm in, you know, it's, I've read that 80 pages in not very long time. It's, yeah, I think I'm really going to like it. I'm going to try and squeeze it into my October stuff. But yeah, ta-da, my first month on BookTube, my first month of setting a TBR ever in my life, and my first month of a wrap-up. So thanks for joining me on my little September, my first month in BookTube, and yeah, I'm really excited to for October and to do the same. So if you like this, subscribe. First time I've ever said that. If you like this video, please subscribe, and I will speak to you very soon. Take care. Bye.